distinction in a school if you are not working hard to get that distinction. Any result you get reflects of who you are. It reflects also the amount of time and strength and the resources you invested in order to get that result. Don't forget, everything depends on you. John 15 verse 1. Jesus said, I'm the true vine. My Father is the owner of the vineyard. Every branch in me that does not bear fruit, he cut it off. And every branch in me that does bear fruit, he prunes that they bear more much fruit. So you are already clean because of the word that I speak unto thee. Abide in me and I in you. Just a branch cannot bear fruit unless they abide in the vine. It's been cut off and withered. They cast the front bed down. So anyone who cannot abide in me. So abide in me and I in you. For without me, you can do nothing. John 15 from verse 1 to 5. Jesus is the vine. We are the branches. God the Father is the owner of the vineyard. What is the assignment of God the Father? Is to tend the vineyard. Weed it, put manure, water it, protect it. What's the work of the vine tree? Is to get the water, distribute the water to the branches. What's the work of the branches? Is to bear fruit. You and I bear the branches. All the things we want, peace, joy, this breakthrough, that breakthrough, greatness, so and so, it bear on us. And Jesus said, I choose that you go and bear fruit, the fruit that will remain. The fruit that will remain. You cannot bear joy if you are disconnected from Jesus. You cannot bear love if you are disconnected from Jesus. Unless you are connected to Him, forget about bearing the fruit. We are so hungry and thirsty for those fruits. We want success. We want that, we want that, we want that. That's why he told us in Matthew 6, 33, first seek ye the kingdom of heaven, this righteousness, and all other things shall be added unto thee. Your connection with God is the most important thing. If you are properly connected to Him, definitely you will bear fruit. Definitely you will bear fruit. Take the lead. Don't sleep because your wife, she's also sleeping, she's not praying. Don't go to bed. You pray, take the lead. Your prayer will help her to overcome that satanic injection of sleep. Don't eat because your husband is always eating. Take the lead to fast. Your fasting will help him to overcome gluttony. Take the lead. Take the lead. Don't just wish for things to change for good in your life or around you. It's time for you to stand up and cause the change that you want to see happening. Don't wait for someone to ask you about Jesus. Take the lead to introduce them to Jesus. When people are telling you their problems, it's not to you they are telling. God brought them to you so that you will bring them to Him, for He is the solution. Something happened. Some of our brethren traveled out of the country and on their way back on Sunday. So in the airport, one of them was attacked. And one of them that was the one they attacked started commanding and calling the attacked one to come back. Commanding, wake up, let us go. That's knowing the Lord your God. Not when you get panicked, looking for a pastor. You need to walk with the Lord. Knowing calling upon God when you need to call upon Him. Yes, we need to call upon Him every moment. But you have to take the lead. Many of us here, we have grown enough in the Lord. It's time for us to take the lead and then go out to fish people for Jesus Christ. Before we introduce people to the church, let us introduce them to Jesus Christ. That's why every one of us, you need to pray for wisdom of God. You need to pray for the anointing of God upon your life. The anointing of God upon your life. So when you're going to bring them to the church, you already passed them. You already experienced the power of God in your life. And they will say, Jesus Christ is Lord. They will say, Jesus Christ is Lord. Say, hey, you are just a very church member, yes. But I'm not an ordinary Christian. You know,